First pitch coming at you right after the break. From Minute Maid Park in Houston, MLB The Show brings you the American League Division Series. It's the Seattle Mariners taking on the Houston Astros. John Ciampi and Chris Singleton with you. Postseason baseball, Singy, it's always great to see and be a part of.
Oh, Boog, you just never know what's in store when it comes to postseason baseball. You do know you're going to see some amazing pitching, guys coming out of the bullpen throwing 100, some incredible defensive plays, some big knocks, and maybe a mistake or two that'll live on forever. All I do know is I'm pumped up for this one.
All right, we'll be back to get this one started after this. Just a little bit away from first pitch. Now the starting pitcher in this one, Framber Valdez.
Yeah, got the W last time out. Six innings, a quality start. Hey, if a guy will give you that, you'll take it every single time.
So just about set now. Here's Adam Frazier. The 1-2. Yeah, the 1-2 misses to even the count. Packed house here at Minute Maid. Two two now. Up the middle, and that's a base hit. And the leadoff man aboard.
Just kept it simple. Played Pepper with the middle of the infield and took it back where it came from, and there's just no one there to knock it down.
And now, Ty France. The pitch. Check swing didn't go, and the count is 3-1. The pitch, and ball four to aboard.
Now, this was a story we were paying attention to before the game. We've seen him give up walks in the past, and it's an issue once again early on.
Here's Jesse Winker, and a 1-1. Double play ball to second. There's one. On to Gurriel. Two. Now batting Mitch Haniger. Frazier on third with two out. Up the middle. That's a base hit as a run scores.
Well, they strike first as he gets the job done to bring home the run. Really nice job staying up the middle with his approach. He didn't try to do too much with the pitch, just shot it through the infield.
So, man aboard, Eugenio Suarez up to hit down. Kicks and deals. Swing and a tapper that rolls foul.
I think it's huge that they were able to score right away. You're playing on the road, stakes are high, energy in the ballpark, and you help to quiet that down a little bit.
This one smoked out to left. Brantley makes the catch, and that'll do it. So, one run in the inning on this base hit. And the home team down a run. back here in Houston and getting the nod for game seven on the hill, Nick Margavichus. What should we keep an eye on here?
Well, there are going to be a lot of balls in play because of the ground ball rate. Important that the defense stays engaged in the game. I think it's critical. Tempo is there. If you work quickly, it helps the fielders behind you to stay engaged, to make those plays, and help you get through the innings.
Bottom of the first. Now it's the second baseman, Jose Altuve. And he deals. In the air out towards right center. Haniger sizes this one up. Grabs it on the run. One up, one down. Now we check out the Astros lineup. They're already down a run, so I'm sure they'd like to punch back and even things up early.
Yeah, it's never a good feeling, especially at your home ballpark, to go down in the first inning. So the best way is just to come out aggressive, try to tie the ball game up, but not just tie it up. Take the lead. I tell you what, momentum can really swing, and you can put your pitcher back in a position where he feels his most confident.
That one fouled off, 2-2. Just off the inside edge. Is there a little wrinkle to that? I think there was.
Yeah. Little slider action.
The pitch. Swing and a miss. The velocity blasted it right past him. Two outs. Base is empty. Here's Alex Bregman.
Alex Bregman.
Rocketed out towards right center. And they get Bregman for the out. And that'll do it. On to the second inning now from Minute Maid Park. It's the Mariners 1 and the Astros nothing. And welcome back. All set for the start of the inning. Now it's the shortstop, J.P. Crawford.
Well, on paper, it's favorable to have a fairly quick inning here with two of the three hitters he's set to face batting from the left side, same side he throws from.
Next pitch is inside, and now 3-2. Ground ball up the middle. Pena handles the chance. Not in time. An infield knock to start the inning.
Did a nice job getting there. Good throw, but very difficult to get anybody on that one as far as you had to go and throw. You know?
Yeah, no question.
This is Kyle Lewis. Swings through that, and it's a strikeout. And one gone.
Just couldn't catch up on the low 90s fastball right there, and that's a result of a good job of changing speeds. Off-speed pitch on the one before, then sped him up. Pitchers that don't throw real hard have to rely on location and mix it up to speeds. That wasn't the best location with the fastball, but clearly that wasn't the pitch he was looking for at the plate either.
Here's Jared Kelnick. Next one misses, 2-1. Crawford leads off first with one away. Swing and a miss, and now 2-2. Time to check on our umpires. Earl Hendricks calling balls and strikes.
Yeah, well-liked umpire, Boog. Pretty consistent with his zone, so if you're familiar with him and how he works, you won't get too surprised by anything. Sometimes he'll give a little bit off the corner, but nothing too crazy at all. Starting to get some pretty good timing on that breaking ball, but he's going to have to stay ready for a fastball. Don't want to watch one go right by you.
Left-hand hitter waits. Pitch misses there, and it's 3-2.
Really good take, especially with two strikes.
Ninth pitch of the at-bat due next. And he walked him.
So here we go again with the walks. It's been a real struggle finding the zone for him in the past. Now, even if they get out of this jam, these walks add pressure and stress to the entire team.
So here's Murphy now. And a foul ball. And now it's 1-2. On the ground a second, might be two. Good feed, that's one. Not in time at first. It's a fielder's choice. So the batting order turns over. Here's the second baseman, Adam Frazier. Corners are occupied with two down. Swings and sends a rocket to right. Tucker makes the catch, and that'll do it. Mariners leave a couple, but they're on top 1-0. Welcome back. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. Now, your Don Alvarez. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. The pitch. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. One away.
Nice. Doubled up with the slider for that punch out. The one before just caught the zone. So as a hitter, you have to protect right there. Great pitch to just expand a little bit more. He got that chase he was looking for. That right there is good pitching.
Yuli Gurriel comes up to hit. On the ground, right side. On to France. Two up, two down.
Batting fifth. The right fielder. Kyle Tucker.
Here's Kyle Tucker. Here comes a pitch. That misses. And a count 2-1. On the ground. It's in and out of his glove. But in time. Nice job to stay with it to end the inning. Nothing doing there for Houston. Still behind by a count of 1-0. Onto the third inning, and stepping in for the Mariners, Ty France. The pitch. Fought off foul.
He needs a quick 1-2-3 this time around. Last inning, threw a lot of pitches.
here it comes. That one the other way. Takes it in for the out.
Now that designated hitter, Jesse Winker
now at the plate. He's 0 for 1. And now the lefty. And another ball.
2-1 the count now. He hasn't seen a fastball yet, but you've got to be ready to hit one because you doubt the pitcher wants this to go to a 3-1 count.
The 2-1. And that one is lifted in the air. Brantley under it. He's got it, and there's two away. And next will be the cleanup hitter, Mitch Haniger. Here's a 1-2. And a foul ball, he stays alive. Two outs. And it's even up. Here's a swing and a drive left field, and he knew it. Mitch Haniger sends it out. That's his third home run of the series. And they add a run. It's 2-0.
A breaking ball on the inside part of the play requires a hitter to stay really square with his mechanics. If you fly open with the front shoulder, there's no way you keep that ball fair. An outstanding job mechanically. He deserves that home run.
Two outs, nobody on. Stepping in, the long ball threat, Eugenio Suarez. The wide to kick the pitch. Right through there, got it. Down on strikes, and he knew it. But add on one more as the solo shot stretches their lead even further. And it's 2-0. Back here at the ballpark, bottom of the inning, and stepping in for the Astros, Chaz McCormick. Foul ball. And a pitch. Stays alive. The big lefty turns, kicks, deals. And a foul ball, he stays alive.
Pitcher having a pretty tough time getting that swing and miss. Third foul ball in a row.
In the air, center field. Lewis on the move. Nice grab on the run. And there's one away.
Batting it. The shortstop.
Jeremy Peña up next for the Astros. Next offering is way upstairs. A wind and a pitch. Cut on and miss. Struck him out. And two away now.
He came out of his mechanics there. Typically likes to shoot the ball the other way, but that time, a little anxious.
Maldonado.
Two outs, base is empty. And now the veteran catcher, Martin Maldonado. Next pitch, not close, up high. Kicks and fires. Popped up. Crawford under it. Puts the squeeze on that one, and that'll end the inning. Nine straight retired here to start the game. Three innings are complete now in Game 7. It's the Mariners 2 and the Astros nothing. Start of the fourth, and the batter now, J.P. Crawford. And a pitch. That misses off the outside edge.
Three balls and no strikes.
And a pitch. Yeah. And it's filled up.
You got a full count.
The wind of the pitch. In the air, left side. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. One away. Here's the center fielder, Kyle Lewis. He struck out swinging at his first at bat. The pitch.
That's the ball. Count is full.
And that's ball four.
Take your base.
What a battle. It's not always easy laying off a 3-2 pitch, and I tell you what, he earned that walk.
Jared Kelnick up next for the Mariners. The pitch to the right side. They get one. Back to the pitcher covering. It's a double play. Nicely done, and that'll do it. On now to the bottom of the fourth. It's the Mariners 2 and the Astros nothing. Back here at Minute Maid Park. Now it's the second baseman, Jose Altuve. Next pitch is outside. And here it comes. Now a screamer into the outfield. Makes the catch, and there's one gone.
The left fielder, number 23, Michael Brantley.
Here's the left fielder, Michael Brantley. Struck out swinging his first time. The Astros hitless so far in the game. That one in for a strike, 2-2.
He's pitching well, but not throwing a ton of first pitch strikes. Usually doesn't work out for success, but he can never predict baseball.
And he deals. Swing and a pop-up. Foul territory for the catcher. Murphy settles under it and makes the catch. Two away.
Third baseman number 2, Alex Bregman.
Two outs, bases empty. Alex Bregman up next for the Astros. Ball to strike. Out to short. Now the throw to first on the run. That ends the frame.
Pure athleticism on that one. In the air, legs split a bit, and fires across the diamond. He's going to get a lot of high fives in the dugout.
Here in Houston, ready now for the fifth inning, and here's the catcher, Tom Murphy. Kicks and deals. Swing and a miss.
He's pitching well, but not throwing a ton of first pitch strikes. Usually doesn't work out for success, but you can never predict baseball.
Two and two.
Next one in the dirt. Line drive, base hit, right field. Now he'll turn for second. In safely, it's a leadoff double in the fifth.
Really stayed inside that baseball to send it to the opposite field. With the shift onto the pole side, that's an easy knock if you'll take it.
So digging in, Adam Frazier. Singled and scored back in the first. He's one for two. Next offering misses, and it's 2-1.
Two balls, one strike.
And a pitch. This one high in the air to left center. Brantley makes the grab, one down. Ty France, the next to hit. And 1-2.
One, two.
The Astros have some action in their pen. Rafael Montero, the veteran right-hander, appears to be loosening up. Maton getting loose as well. Swings and misses, two down.
It's almost like he's telling the guys in the bullpen, stand down, I got this.
Now batting, the designated hitter, Jesse Winker.
Now it's the DH, Jesse Winker. Here's a 1-1. Next offering misses down and away. Fouls one off, 2-2. And there's a ball. This one in the air, center field. McCormick racing over to make the catch. One left for Seattle. They're up 2-0. Back here in Houston, John Schauby with my buddy Chris Singleton. It's set to get us started. Bottom five, your Don Alvarez. Lifted in the air, right center field. Lewis moving under it. Puts it away for the out.
Now batting, first baseman, Ulieski.
Now it's Yuli Gurriel. The Astros yet to pick up a hit here. Swing and a line drive, base hit out of the center field. So they get a man aboard with a one-out single.
just so sound in his mechanics. Hits against a firm front side, and the hands just continue to carry through the middle of the field.
One gone, runner at first. And next to hit for Houston, Kyle Tucker. The 1-1. And now the count, 1-2 after the swing and the miss. Gurriel, the base runner at first with one out. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. Now two out.
Well, that's the moneymaker right there. Two strikes, slider down and away from a same side thrower as the hitter. I mean, that's just tough. You're looking to protect with two strikes and very difficult to lay off.
Digging in, it's the speedy outfielder, Chaz McCormick. Tying run at the plate. Good eye in that spot. There's a strike. Two two now. Squirts away a little bit. Tag safe at second. And good hustle to move up. That's a wild pitch. Back to work. 3-2 now. And down on strikes he goes. Third out, and that ends the frame. He continues to roll on the mound as five shutout innings are in the books. Five innings complete. It's the Mariners 2 and the Astros nothing. And welcome back. Top six. And now it's the cleanup hitter for the Mariners, Mitch Haniger. Next pitch is downstairs. Now with the shift on, hits right into it. In time to Gurriel. And they take care of Haniger for the out.
Now back, the third baseman, Eugenio Suarez.
Eugenio Suarez up to the plate now. Here comes a pitch. Good eye right there. The pitch. That one missed. Three one is on the way. Little chopper rolls foul. One down, base is empty. Fouled off again, and it remains 3-2. The wind of the pitch stays alive. And now the lefty to third. Bregman to first. Two quick outs to open the top of the sixth.
Now that the shortstop, J.P. Crawford.
At the plate, J.P. Crawford. Next pitch is outside.
2-1.
Left-hand hitter waits. Bounce to the right. Altuve handles it, throws to first, and that is that. 8-9-1 scheduled in the bottom of the sixth. It's the Mariners 2 and the Astros nothing. Bottom of the sixth inning, and now Jeremy Pena.
Well, these fans definitely want to get involved in the game, all it's going to take is to get the leadoff man or even a base runner on.
The wide to kick the pitch. Line drive. Frazier on to first in time. One away, bottom of the sixth.
Up next to the Astros, the catcher, Martin Maldonado.
Martin Maldonado up to hit.
Well, on the mound, very efficient, able to produce an outcome, it seems like, within the third or fourth pitch of just about every at bat.
Kicks and fires. On the ground, right side. On to France. And a couple of quick outs.
Well, he's doing a nice job of keeping the ball out of the air, lets the defense work behind him with another ground ball. Good execution.
Jose Altuve up to hit here. And a count one and two.
Looked like you got a little excited on that fastball. Got to think to yourself, I want to stay up the middle. That way, if you're a little bit early, you hit it out of the ballpark. If you're a little late, opposite field knock.
And it goes just foul. Next offering is foul back. One and two now. Altuve waits. On the ground to third. Suarez throw to first in time. And the inning is over. Astros go down 1-2-3. They trail it here 2-0. New pitcher on now, Rafael Montero. And his job is to collect quick outs and keep his team within striking distance.
Rafael Montero.
We go to the top of the seventh. And now for Seattle, Kyle Lewis. And the righty deals. Swing and a high fly ball down the left field line, but hooking foul. One, two now. Gets under and pops it up. Makes the grab, and there's one away.
Man, he just couldn't lay off right there. Those high fastballs, they just look really good because they're eye level, but they're just about impossible to get the barrel to.
Now the left fielder, Jared Kelnick. Strike two.
They can live up in the zone all game if guys will chase it. That's just too much velocity. Hitters got to look down in the zone.
And there's a fly ball deep right field. That's back. Pulls it in on the warning track.
Maybe caught that one off the end just a little bit. Couldn't quite barrel it up enough to really drive it.
Now it's Tom Murphy. Next offering is foul back. Three, two now. And a foul ball. He stays alive. Eighth pitch of the at bat coming up. Swing and a miss. And he's down on strikes. And the Mariners set down 1-2-3. Mariners go down quietly there, but they hold the 2-0 lead. here at the ballpark. Bottom of the seventh, Michael Brantley to start things off. Swing and a miss. Struck him out, and that's the first out. A big first out here in the seventh via the punch out.
Yeah, it just does so much to change the outlook of an important inning like this. When you got the leadoff hitter, so critical in setting the table when you got a tight game like this. So a strikeout really puts them on their heels.
And now it's Alex Bregman. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. Stays alive. The wind and the pitch. That's out to center field. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And there's two away.
Now batting, the designated hitter, Yordan Alvarez.
Two outs, base is empty. Here's Yordan Alvarez. The pitch. That one ripped. And that should be extra bases. Around first and hustling for second. He's there. It's a two-out double.
Really nice job of two-strike hitting in that at-bat. Textbook bat control right there. Got a pitch on the outside, saw it deep into the zone, and just barreled it up, went the other way for the knock. And you can feel this crowd waking up a bit here as the guys are starting to make some noise with their bats.
Here's Gurriel. The tying run at the plate.
These fans, they are ready to cheer about something.
Alvarez at second with two down. Next one is off the plate, and that's ball three. Some activity in the Mariners bullpen. Paul Sewald up and throwing. Castillo getting cranked up as well. And a 3-1 on the way. That to right. Haniger makes the catch, and that'll do it. One left for Houston. They trail things here 2-0. The Astros turn to a new arm on the mound, Phil Maton. And he'll do his best to keep this close. Here's the second baseman, Adam Frazier. And a count 1-2. Next pitch has popped up. That's a hit. So a man on base to start the inning.
The first baseman, number 23, Ty Frank.
And up next for Seattle, Ty France. Right-hander kicks, deals. And there he goes. Swing and a ball lifted in the air, left field, pretty well struck. Gone! Ty France goes deep. His second home run of the series. It's 4-0.
There was a cutter away. Kind of works like a slider. You've got to stay on it, let it travel a little bit, and then get your arms extended. Really good piece of hitting right there.
And next is the designated hitter, Jesse Winker. The 1-1. And another ball.
can be tough to bounce back after a big home run, but nobody on, nobody out. You just have to treat it as a fresh inning.
Yeah, the 2-1 hammered but foul. And the right-hander deals. The punch out there. One out.
Well, he throws him with a great fastball right on the corner. It's kind of like bowling when you think the ball's going to get into the gutter and somehow just hangs onto that edge and knocks down a pin. Well, he got the outside corner of the plate and got that called third strike.
So here's the cleanup hitter, Mitch Haniger. He blasted one out earlier in the third.
Just a solo home run, but an important swing of the bat in this game. We've already seen him do it once. Can he do it again?
That one hit to right. And it's a one-hopper off the wall. Should be extra bases. Altuve with a relay throw. The tag out.
The triple is arguably the most exciting play in baseball. And a guy's worked so hard to get around first, to get around second, and to get thrown out at third. Man, you just feel bad for him. On top of that, he was already in scoring position. So you think about how it kind of hurts the team as well.
Now it's going to be Eugenio Suarez. Ground ball to the right side. Gurriel takes it to the bag, and that'll do it. But two come across to score in the inning, courtesy of this two-run homer. It's now a 4-0 ball game. Back now, new pitcher on the mound as we roll into the bottom of the eighth, Eric Swanson. And he'll work on holding this lead. Back here at Minute Maid Park. Now it's the right fielder, Kyle Tucker. Left-hand batter waits. That smash towards center. And there's a hit. Off to a good start with a leadoff knock.
So impressive that he didn't get tied up or jammed on that pitch inside. Instead, good quick hands allowed him to get the barrel to it, just shoot it up the middle of the field for that knock.
Chaz McCormick will hit next. That one fouled off, 2-2. Pickoff throw, and he's back safely. Nobody out, runner at first. The pitch. Swings through that one, it's a strikeout. And one out now.
Oh, that slider was way out of the zone. And for me, it just comes down to not seeing the pitch out of the hand, not tracking it into the zone, and then also being a little bit anxious, not confident in your two-strike approach. And so when a guy's in that position, you get him to commit early, and a lot of times you get the swing and miss, as you did right there.
Man at first, Jeremy Pena digs in now. Righty delivers. Late swing, fouled off. And a pitch. Lifted in the air, out to left. Kelnick makes the grab, and there are two outs.
Good pitch. He just kind of had him out in front on that pitch away and wasn't able to stay close.
Up next to the Astros, the catcher.
Here's the catcher, Martin Maldonado. Tucker off of first with two away. Tried to check his swing there. Now an appeal to first. And that's ruled a swing. It's a strikeout. So the Astros leave one. They trail it here 4-0. Oh, here we go. Pedro Baez.
The human rain delay. He's sped up this year, though.
Number 52, Pedro Baez.
New inning getting started. And stepping in for the Mariners, J.P. Crawford. At the belt and fires. And it skips in the dirt.
2-1.
In the air, left field. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And there's one down. So up next, Kyle Lewis. The next pitch misses, and a count 2-1.
That's a good miss off the inside part of the plate. You'd much rather miss there than out over the plate where this guy could do some real damage.
The 2-1. Movement in the bullpen. Hector Neris preparing to come on if needed. Three-one, and he couldn't come up with it.
Second walk of the game for him, and he's been really patient at the plate, a game plan that he's sticking to. He's just not going outside of what he's looking for up there.
And now here is Jared Kelnick. The pitch just misses with that one. And a pitch. Hit pretty well in the air out to center. McCormick drifts towards it. Hauls it in for the out. Now the Mariners catcher, Tom Murphy. Next pitch misses. Two balls, two strikes to count with two outs. And now it's filled up.
Great RBI spot here. Just got to stay focused on the pitch. The runner will be in motion, so something in the gap should definitely score it.
And he deals. And down on strikes. That's the third out. To the bottom of the ninth we go. Top of the order, due up. It's the Mariners 4 and the Astros nothing. Back now as they hand the ball to a fresh arm to start the bottom of the ninth. Andres Munoz trying to protect this lead. Welcome back. There's the former MVP, Jose Altuve. Ninth inning elimination game. Chris, it's a tall task. They're going to need a crooked number to tie this game up.
Yeah, and they just have to remember that they have had many innings over the course of the year where they've scored more runs needed than they need in this one. So just relax, get your pitch, and make something happen.
France pulls it down, one up, one down.
That was a good pitch to hit right down the heart of the plate. Had pretty good timing on it. Just got underneath it a little bit and popped it up.
Here's Michael Brantley. The 1-1. Upstairs. Action in the bullpen for Seattle. Anthony Misevich, the lefty, looks to be getting himself ready. Right-handed reliever. That one missing inside. The 3-1 in for a strike, full count. Out towards right center field, Lewis, as he glides to his left, snags it on the run. Out number two.
Baseman number two, Alex Bregman.
Now it's Alex Bregman. Now this is blasted way back there on its way. Gone.
That slider on the outside part of the plate is typically hit the other way, but to be able to get to it, pull the baseball, and get it up in the air for a home run, I'm just really impressed.
Paul Sewald gets the call from the pen. He's being eased into the game here with the bases empty. Yordan Alvarez up next for the Astros.
Really good piece of hitting last time going to the opposite field.
This one is smashed down the right field line. Way back there. Fair and gone.
Back-to-back homers, always a special feeling at the ballpark, especially if it's your team that does it and those guys get to slap hands at home plate. This is the kind of thing that can really fire up a ball club.
Yuli Gurriel up next for the Astros. Two down, nobody on. And that one missing low.
the pitch. There's a strike.
Righty to the plate. 3-2 now.
That turns out to be a really good take right there, but you don't want to end this game with the bat on your shoulder.
Grabs it barehanded, and he throws it away. And he'll pull into second safely.
You know, two-out errors are kind of like two-out walks, and sometimes even worse. You know, you think you're out of the inning, but all of a sudden, you get another out to get, and the offense has a great opportunity they're looking to take advantage of and make you pay for.
And now the right fielder, Kyle Tucker. Two outs. That misses the zone, and it's 2-1.
Oh, an interesting situation. One swing, you can tie up the ball game. But if you're patient and work a walk, then you bring the game-winning run to the plate.
Two-run game, a two away here in the bottom of the ninth. Swing and a ball hammered left field. That's back there. And the Mariners are moving on. They're headed to the American League Championship Series.
Remind you to please drive home safely. Good night.